They want to go to open door. I cut it.
It's very fine. Yes, I do. Let me see. It's nice. Let's look for a top for it. Let me see.
Now,
is
this
set up? I like this one. It's too big now.
It's
me, right? But why is it? Being a disaster.
I know I look up nice.
You don't.
Hello, guys.
Hi, guys.
Hello.
Check.
Something bad
will
come. This is too simple. This is my
size. Yeah,
have to bring one out and
I'm going to bring one out myself.
These are straight. Thank you.
Okay. Okay. It's big. On the game, I'm tired of all these colors. White holes. No, no, I don't really like it.
See white?
Yeah, see white, but it's not as size.
7 to 8.
This is paining me right now because I'm not getting like full size. How many years?
2 to 4.
Full size.
It's
one
size.
It's too big.
Look at how
I'm testing. Let me do that.
Now 1,000.
We live there. Because you're like filming. It's also a thing that I'm trying to play. Yes, scaffold here.
No customer. So while you're watching me make my snack, I just want to talk about a book that I read this week. That book is so good. It's so amazing. Like, it's a book that has everything in one. So if you know that you're a book lover, please try and read this book. It's titled The Last Letter by Rebecca Yarros. If you're not a book lover and you just like to hear the gist, then keep watching. But if you're a book lover and you don't want any spoilers, please just skip this part. I literally cried. I cried my eyes out while reading this book. I kid you not. So it's about two best friends, and these best friends are in the army. They're like soldiers, and you know, one of the best friend has a sister named Ella, and the other best friend has nobody at all. Like, he's very lonely, no family, no friend except his best friend. So this best friend, his name is Ryan, and Ryan has a sister named Ella. So, you know, he just kind of like, you know, asked Ella to be his best friend's pen pal. What's a pen pal? A pen pal is someone you just write to. Your friend by pen, do you get? So they just started writing letters to each other, and started, you know, becoming close through letters. But after a few months, I think about 3 months, the brother Ryan was killed in action. He was killed in action, and he wrote a last letter to his best friend and was like, oh hi, if you're reading this, you know the last letter drill, you made it, I didn't, stuff like that. And he begged his best friend to please go be with his sister Ella. Ella has twins, and the father of the twins is not in the picture. He abandoned the children, abandoned her, and one of the twins has cancer. Do you get? So that's how the best friend left service for a while and then went to be with Ella. So that's how they started, you know, being together and stuff. I don't want to spoil it, but I just want you guys to go and read it, please. Just go and read it. It's so good. Like, you're going to cry because Ella's brother dying is not even the sad part of the book. Do you know, there are more sad parts of the book. So please just go and read it. You're going to love it. So, hi guys. We're heading to the market. We're going to get everything.
Just a leg stew.
We're going to get things to make catfish stew. And I think I'm going to show you guys how to make catfish stew. Because if I show you guys how to make catfish stew, you're going to be hooked for life.
You will have that. No, I want just to. It's not before. I want to start barbecue business. No.
You customer, you know they respect me. Mm-hmm.
No, it's not enough. It's not enough. Which one is that much?
So hi besties, I want to teach you guys how to make catfish stew. So this is my catfish. I got 3 pieces of catfish and I washed them with alum. So when you go to the market and you get your catfish, ask them to give you alum. The people selling the catfish may not have it, but just ask around and you're going to get alum. I used alum to wash this catfish. That's what I used to wash my catfish. I don't like boiling water over it because I feel like water cooks it a little bit. So I just use alum to wash it. And when you wash your catfish, it's going to be this clean. Are you seeing what I'm showing you? It's going to be this clean. And some people say that, oh, some catfish is the breed of catfish can be very dark. But trust me, this one was very dark when I bought it. But after washing with alum, it became light gray. So when your catfish is clean, it has to be light gray in color. Or if it's just the breed, then fine. So I'm going to be seasoning this with some paprika, some salt, some Maggi cubes, some ginger, some garlic, some thyme, onions, some peppers, and what else? I think just basically season how you love to season your protein for your stew. You guys, if you've been looking for that stew that is really, really sweet, like you're the kind of person that your stew is not that, you can cook it, but your stew is not that banging, like, do you understand? Just make catfish stew, see? Make catfish stew. Catfish stew is sweet. It's the truth. Honestly, I can't lie for my besties. Do you understand? Try this soup. Make it and you're going to love it. I don't know why my curry is sprinkling everywhere. That's even the last of it. Anyway, I have a new can in the cupboard. And this is my onions. I always boil my protein with onions. So, yeah. I also added benny as well. And I added lasso fish seasoning. This lasso fish seasoning is the game changer. Whether you're making pepper soup, you're making whatever you're making that requires fish or catfish, whatever, that fish is just the main protein in the food, please do well to add lasso fish seasoning. It's really nice. Honestly, I've been using this for quite a while now and it is very nice. So I'm just going to boil that for less than 10 minutes. I'm boiling for less than 10 minutes because I don't want it to overcook. You want your catfish to be intact. You don't want it to scatter. And then the next step is to put some flour in a bowl and then add in some Maggi cubes, some salt, and some sea pepper. You can decide to not do this if you want, but if you want your stew or your fish to be, you know, very sweet, you can do this. I added in some salt, some Maggi cubes, and sea pepper. So after I added that together, I just mixed that thoroughly and yeah. So once I was done mixing that and my fish was, you know, boiled already, I brought them out, allowed them to cool for a little bit. It's still very hot though because I couldn't wait. And then I started to put the flour all over the body of the fish. I'm doing this because when I want to fry this fish, I don't want it to scatter at all. I want it to be strong. I want it to be intact. So it's good to rub flour all over it. But if you can still skip this process, if you're trying to keep your meals really, really healthy, because flour and oil, anyways, well, if you don't mind, you can do this. But if you mind, you can skip this part. Just make sure that your oil is very, very hot and it might scatter a little bit, but it will not scatter as much as, you know, you get what I mean.
So you have to run back home.
I started to fry. So you're going to let that fry for about 15 minutes on each side. That's 15 minutes. That's like 30 minutes to fry a batch of it. It takes time, but yeah, that's like 30 minutes to fry a batch of it, because you don't want it to scatter. I mean, it's main protein in your food, you don't want it to scatter. So yeah, I fried that and it was very, very crispy. Like, even after I fried, I still dried in my air fryer. I still did that, so it was very crispy. But you can skip the air fryer parts, just make sure that it is very, very dried on fire. This is my stew. I didn't film this part because we all know how to make stew already. My tomatoes is not very smooth. This is how we like it. This is how my husband likes it. So yeah, I don't like to blend very smooth. I just like to, you know, just blend a little bit. And yeah, that's it. You see how my fish is looking? See, this fish is sweet. I don't know, but catfish is the sweetest kind of fish. Like, I've not eaten any kind of fish that's as sweet as catfish. Honestly, I'm not even joking. Fight me for this, but catfish is the sweetest fish ever. Titus is not even close. So I don't want to hear anything like Titus in my comment section, because Titus is not even close to this. So after frying that, just take it out of the oil and fry your fish till you're done frying all the pieces that you cut out. So once you're done making your stew and you feel like your stew is done, like your stew is well fried, you can now add in your fish. You allow that to boil for about maybe 5-10 minutes, so you know the fish can soak inside the stew and release its own flavor in the stew. And then your stew is ready. See, everybody's going to love it. When visitors taste my catfish stew, they are always like, oh my god, it's always nice. It eats every time. So please, if you've never tried it, please do try it. Added some spring onions for some more flavor, and then that was it. My catfish stew was done and ready. I paired this with some white rice, some plantains, and yeah.
Yes, so long as you know what to do.